accepted.
Toa Harada, Yuna Yamashita, which one is cuter?
What's good, everybody? Curl Necker here for the Curl Necker Network, and today I plan to answer that question in our first of many kawaii battles.
So let's get a definition going. We're going to say attractive or pretty, especially in a childish, youthful, or delicate way. This is the definition for cute that we're going for in this video. Also, for those who are wondering, the idol in the corner is Mei Yamazaki, also known as Panda Sun from Morning Musume. So now that we have that definition out there, it should be easy to understand that beauty and cute are not the same thing. In fact, someone can be more beautiful, but not more cute. Let's use the example we're here with. Akari Mori is more beautiful than Ririko Urimura, or Ririko Urimura is more cute than Akari Mori. See what we got there? So now that you understand what I'm going for, let's start this battle of the cutest. So here we have Toa Harada from Girls Girls, and Yuna Yamashita from Ice Cream. Now, both of them are the cutest member in their own respective groups, so what factors can we use to decide which one is the cuter of the two? If you remember our definition, the more childish, youthful, or delicate something is, the cuter it is. So an easy way to go off of this is, let's look at their face. So which one of them has more of a baby face? That means it would have less dominant features and it would be more softer and rounder looking. For example, while I think Ikuchi Asada was one of the prettiest members in Lucky Lucky, I don't think she's one of the cutest members. I don't know. I guess it's that big manly mall Giga Chad jaw she has just knocks her to the bottom of the cute list, yet it keeps her at the top of the pretty list. So let's start round one, Battle of the Babyface. So let's start off on Toa's side. As you can see, no dominant facial features, pretty smooth, pretty rounded head. Though, if you look a little close, there is just a little bit of sharpness to it, but again, that's pretty darn round. So yes, she gets pretty high marks on this one. So now let's look at Yuna's side. Yep, not a single dominant trait anywhere there. Like, that is probably the roundest head I've ever seen on an idol. Certain facial expressions, you see a tiny bit of sharpness, but that, look at that. Look at that spherical dome. You all knew who was gonna win this round as soon as we started this one. Nobody has a rounder head than her. So round one, obvious winner, Yuna Yamashita in this round. So for the second round, we're going to be looking at size. It's no surprise that the smaller and more compact something is, the cuter it is. This is why people agree that Spill is cuter than Celio and Walrein, and why they also agree that the Lilties are cuter than the Yukes in the Final Fantasy series. And so with our two lovely ladies, Toa and Yuna, who's the smaller of the two? So round two, let's get it started. Who is the cuter size? Coming in at just 158 centimeters, roughly 5'2" for the Americans out there, Toa lands a critical hit. I think it's safe to say that Toa went. Yuna is actually shorter, coming in at 4'11" or 151 centimeters. That's right, she is under the 5 foot mark, the epitome of cute. And so with this, Yuna picks up round two as well. Can she make a clean sweep? Stay tuned. Round three is all about the voice. And no, we're not talking about their singing voice. It's just their normal speech voice. And though I want to believe we all can agree that Yuna has a better singing voice, better vocally does not mean cuter. And so, using the definition which is provided at the beginning of the video by Merriam-Webster, in case you were wondering, we're looking for who has the most youthful, childlike, and delicate voice to determine who has the cuter voice of the two. So let's go. Round three. Place your bets, people. So let's start off with Toa. Here, have a listen. Yep, you heard that just like I did. The only word I can think of to categorize Toa's cute voice is supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, which is a made-up word. This is incredibly one-sided, but for the sake of fairness, let's hear Yuna's voice. So yeah, round three goes to Toa, easily. While Yuna's voice is also cute, it's just your average run-of-the-mill Japanese girl voice. Toa's voice, very distinctive, you can't mistake it. Now we're getting to the good part. Round four is all about facial expressions and mannerisms. Cute mannerisms and facial expressions are a huge factor in deciding who's cuter because they can instantly increase a person's cuteness level. Now both Toa and Yuna are known for having very cute facial expressions, so this should be a very interesting one. So let's go. Facial expressions, Toa,
Yuna. Round 4, who wins? If you're a Toa fan, you already know you're going into this one with an advantage. Who doesn't know about the Toa-chan smile? And it's not just a smile. I've been on the record several times saying that Toa has the most memeable face in all of J-pop. But does this memeability translate into cuteness? Now, Yuna actually comes in at a bit of a disadvantage, because sometimes she can smile so hard that she makes herself look like Midna from Twilight Princess. Now, while her resting face is one of the cutest things in the world, her facial expressions actually take away from it, so it puts her at a disadvantage. Needless to say, Toa wins round 4. Really, did you expect anything else? The Toa-chan smile, come on. Well, it's a draw game so far. You're probably on the edge of your seat and wondering what's going to be the final deciding factor to decide who is the cutest between Toa Harada and Yuna Yamashita. Why, none other than personality. It is the epitome of what makes a person cute. You have a person that looks weird, but with a cute enough personality, they can pull it off. So let's get into the final round to decide who is the cutest of the two. First up, we'll look at Toa. Toa likes to be edgy a little bit. More on the cooler side of things. In fact, there's not really much cute about her personality, but she is just naturally goofy. She can't help it. So is that enough with her cute voice and facial expressions and mannerisms to give her the win? The words that come to mind when I think of Yuna are delicate, dainty, cutesy. She is one of the most feminine of feminine idols. Yes, she has a cooler side to her when she does like the rap parts of the songs and everything, but Yuna's not afraid to just revel in her own cuteness from time to time. And that is a good thing. So, you want to know who wins overall. And it was a tough competition the whole time, but I have to give the win to none other than the world's cutest idol, Yuna Yamashita. Now here's the thing, though this battle is over, we can probably revisit this in a few years, cause Toa has the potential to beat her, only she prefers to be more of the cool, cutesy, almost tomboyish type. If Toa just really just dives headfirst into her cuteness and just revel in it the way Yuna does, I can see her beating her. But as it stands, Yuna's the champ.
So, agree, disagree, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Also, if you have other people that you want to see be part of the whole Kawaii Battles, let me know in the comment section below. And if it's a good enough one that I feel like I have enough information on them to do a proper battle on it, I will probably just do that. But I already have something in mind for number 2, and I hope you guys stick around for that. In the meantime, how about checking out this one, which is my own personal favorite, or this if you want a good selection of all the best that we have to offer on the Cutest Network.